morning students, today I am going to take science class. The lesson name is organ system. The last time we had seen the digestive system and the respiratory system. In this lesson we are going to see the circulatory system. Okay, now the circulatory system, in this system the blood is, first of all, the blood is circulated to transport the oxygen and nutrients to every part of the body. Enna oxygen um nutrients um enna pannona ka nammoda body full ah poittu varum because of the heart. Heart ipdi pump aayi varudilla adha circulatory system contains the heart, blood vessels and the blood. Now we are going to see the organs of heart. The heart is a hollow muscular organ and the shape is looks like a conical shape. It is covered with the double walled membrane and is called the pericardium. The space between the membranes filled with the pericardial fluids. These pericardial fluids protects the heart from the shock. Heart is placed between inside the thoracic chamber in between the two lungs. Okay, look the diagram. See the diagram. The diagram here there are four chambers, 1, 2, 3, 4. The heart is divided into the four chambers. Two upper chambers are called the atria, right atrium and the left atrium. The two lower chambers are called the ventricles, that are right ventricle and the left ventricle. The upper and the lower chambers of the heart are separated by the muscular tissue known as the auriculoventricular septum of the heart. The right side of the right side of the heart receives the deoxygenated blood from the various parts of the body and pumps to the lungs for the oxygenation. Next, the left side of the heart receives the oxygenated blood from the lungs and pumps it to the different parts of the body. Okay students, okay, I will tell you one more time. There are four chambers. There are right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle and the left ventricle. This is called the upper chambers and this is called the lower chambers. This is the right side. The right side of the heart receives the deoxygenated means impure blood. Impure blood from the various parts of the body and pumps it to the lungs for the oxygenation. And the left side of the heart receives the oxygenated blood from the lungs and pumps into the different parts of the body. Right students? Okay, this is about the heart. Next one is blood vessel. Blood vessel consists arteries, veins and the capillaries. Arteries carry the oxygenated blood and veins carry the deoxygenated blood. The capillaries are thin blood vessels which connect the arteries and the veins. The capillaries connects the arteries and the veins. The arteries carry the oxygenated blood and the veins carry the deoxygenated blood. They help in exchange the materials between the circulatory system and the body tissue. Next one is blood. Blood transport the oxygen, nutrients, waste and removes the hormones. The volume of the blood for human adults is 4 to 5 liters. It regulates the water level and the body temperature. Blood is pumped through the throughout the body of the heart. Throughout the body by the heart, it takes oxygen to the tissues and the cells. Finally, it will reach the lungs to take oxygen again. Next one is, do you know there are some animals like the lobsters and crabs that have the blue color blood, but and the cockroach has white color blood, or we can say that colorless. Okay, next one is, place your right index and the middle finger on the palm side of your left wrist. Okay, then count the number of beats for 5 seconds and then multiply this by the 4 then we get the 60. This shows the many times the heartbeats in one time. Next one is excretory system. The excretory system removes the waste from our body and it also regulates water and electrolyte balance. Kidneys, lungs, liver and the skin together function as the excretory system. The excretory organs are kidneys, ureteries, urinary bladder. Next. Okay. The kidney filter the blood, remove the waste and produce the urine. The kidneys are pair of dark red and their shape is bean shaped. Organs placed behind the abdomen. எதுக்கு பின்னாடி இருக்கும் அப்டமனுக்கு பின்னாடி இருக்கும் on the either side of the vertebral column. The average adult's kidneys measures about 12 cm length, 6 cm width and the thickness is 3 cm. Okay, right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney. Each kidney is covered by the fibrous membrane called the capsule. The kidneys are made up of millions of the excretory units called the nephrons, which are the structural and functional unit of the kidneys. The kidneys la vandittu blood ellathiyum blood la irukla waste ellathiyum remove panni urine produce pannidom. The enna color la irukonuna pair of dark in color and it is shape is bean shaped. One is ureters. Two ureters connects the kidneys. This connects the kidneys with the urinary bladder. Urine formed from each kidney and reaches the urinary bladder through the ureters. Kidneys வந்து என்ன பண்ணோம் இதுல produce பண்ணி urinary bladder ல produce பண்ணோம். Next one, urinary bladder. It is like a sac in shape and act as a temporary storage organ of the urine. Urine enters like this to the urinary bladder through the ureters. Slowly fill the hollow space inside the bladder and urine is expelled from the body through the urethra. Homework is, name the chambers in our human heart. You have to write the 4 chambers. What are they? Lower chambers and the upper chambers. 2 chambers are called atria and the or auricles. The 2 lower chambers are called ventricles. This is the homework for you. Thank you, students. See you in the next class.